Hey guys, today I'm working on my motorcycle. I'm going to extract a broken off bolt. What happened was the spline shaft that the Kickstarter mounts to has a bolt that holds it on from this side that screws into the center of the shaft, and that sheared off about flush with the end of the shaft for the Kickstarter. So I'm going to have to drill that out, and I'm going to have to use an extractor tool to pull that out so I can put a new bolt in and mount this back to the bike. For this job, you're going to need a crescent wrench, a set of extractor bits, a centering punch, a hammer, a set of drill bits, and a drill.
So you can see from this angle that the bolt snapped off right inside the spline shaft where the Kickstarter is supposed to slide over, and that bolt's supposed to hold the Kickstarter on. So what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to drill that out and use a extracting tool to pull that bolt out so we can get the new one in.
So I'm gonna start out by using a centering punch to put an indent on the end of the broken off bolt so that when I go to drill out the center of it, I get it as close to the center of the hole as possible. Now the concern here is that if you don't go and drill into that shaft straight, you'll wind up messing up the threads on the inside of the shaft here. So you want to make sure that when you center punch your shaft, it is exactly in the middle, and you use a small enough drill bit so that you don't wind up messing up the threads on the inside. So, all right, beautiful. So we have the center of the broken off bolt has a divot in the end of it. Now I'm going to use a 1/8 inch drill bit here. And just a regular hand drill. And I'm going to drill a pilot hole. And that's essentially just a smaller hole so that when I use a larger bit, it'll go in straight. It's easier to drill it out this way. So I want to be very careful that I get the drill bit lined up straight and I don't mess up the threads. So let's see what happens here. It's not perfectly in the center, but it's close enough away from the threads that it shouldn't cause a problem. Alright, so something interesting just happened. The drill bit has actually managed to start screwing in that shaft, the broken off shaft from the bolt. So it's further in there than it was when I started. So what I'm using here is an extractor bit, and basically what that has is teeth on it that are reverse from they turn counterclockwise as you screw it in. So as you can see, the shaft is tapered, as it goes in, it gets a better and better bite on the bolt that you're trying to extract, which allows you to unscrew it and pull it out. So what you want to do is you want to get that lined up on the hole you drill, and then you want to take your hammer and just tap that in, and that's going to seat the teeth on that hole you just drilled, but you don't want to turn it in too tight. Now, it looks like it's loose enough, I can actually unscrew it by hand, which is really surprising. It rarely happens. But usually you'd use a crescent wrench or something like that to fit on the end of this boxed end and unscrew it if the threads were still tight. But it looks like it's not going to be an issue this go around. And what you get when you're done is the snapped off bolt. So now I should just be able to throw in my old Kickstarter, put a new bolt in, and I'm gonna go out riding.
So here you can get a little better look at the shaft that I just pulled out, the broken off bolt. As you can see, I didn't quite get that hole drilled exactly in the center, which is okay as long as it doesn't mess up the threads, but you do want it as close to the center as possible, and you want that hole to be drilled as straight down the shaft as possible so you don't mess up the threads. What you can also see here is those score marks on the inside of that hole, and that's from the extractor bit. And what happens is, since it's a tapered shaft with teeth on it, as it goes in deeper, it gets a more and more snug fit, and allows you to torque on it harder and get a better bite on it if this bolt is being stubborn with you and doesn't want to come out. Like in some cases where you have thread locker on the threads, it doesn't come out quite as easily as it does this time. And I was just able to unscrew it with my fingers, which doesn't usually happen.
So you can see here, I got the bolt extracted. I got a new bolt in. I'm using a washer to actually hold it in place, because I don't have the exact bolt from the factory, but I'm using one I pulled out of my bolt bucket and a washer, and that's going to have to do for now, because I kind of want to go hit the trail. I think that problem has been solved.
What? Okay. Shit.
You guys are probably coming up here. Maybe, I don't know. Put that back on for you.
Did it break or just a bolt?
I don't know.
The bolt that holds it.
Yeah, the one that goes inside because it screws into the end.
Oh.
So it's snapped off inside. We're going to have to drill it.
I see how it works. I thought it was like a pinch bolt.
No. Yeah. Cool.
That's amazing.
The moral of the story, bring extra bolts, an easy out kit, a drill. Yeah, just throw it in your backpack with everything else.
I have that seal epoxy stuff, whatever you call it. That'll help. Surface to hold on.
If I can just tuck it somewhere here in my pack.
Yeah.
And impale myself in my own Kickstarter.
Just make sure it's in a place.
I just won't turn it off.
There you go. Or stop on hills like I used to do on the XR. Always on the top of a hill.
We should see this one right here.
There you go.
I like hit the top, I just didn't have quite enough speed, and I stopped with like the front tire barely at the
I
top.
I saw you sitting there.
Fuck! Well, I mean, at least you can finish the ride.
Yeah.
I'll go back for that.
You just gotta find a place to tuck it.
So. Yeah, it's a weight reduction.
You know. There you go. It's in your bag instead of mine.
Hey, what's in my bag? I can weigh 50 pounds.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions or comments, put them in the comment section below. We'll get to those as soon as we can. Please like this video and also subscribe to our channel. And if you want to see more of our videos, you can see those here as well. Thanks.